In the early stages of the pandemic, environmentalists were thrilled at some of the positive impacts it was having on our air quality and other types of pollution as people drove less and stayed home. But after nearly a year, a lot of those gains are gone, and other environmental problems have actually gotten worse, like trash. Our lockdown lifestyle has produced a higher volume of litter, from disposable masks to plastic food containers, all a result of takeout dining and other COVID safety measures. Adding to the challenge, environmental groups like San Diego Surf Rider Foundation says they can't host public events to help clean up the coast and are now relying on individual volunteers to fill the gap.
Beach cleanups are complicated. It's a big public in-person event. I think the last one before COVID started had 400 people in Ocean Beach. So our public beach cleanups have had to halt, as everyone's public events have. But the cleanup effort is still going on. It's just happening in a solo capacity. So people are being tasked to either just go out in their neighborhood and pick up trash around their neighborhoods, because as we know, all of San Diego is a watershed that leads to the beach. Or you can go out to a couple different locations throughout OB, La Jolla, and PB and pick up actual cleanup supplies. And with your household, perform a cleanup like it was one of our classic surf rider beach cleanups.
So you've had to get a little bit creative to keep your environmental cleanup going.
Yeah, we have. It's been, the most difficult thing has been data. So data is one of the biggest functions from beach cleanups. It's an amazing education tool, but mostly we collect data from that to be able to help influence legislation on science and facts, showing what exactly is showing up on our beaches, what exactly is showing up in our ocean. So trying to get that data out has been the most difficult. But outside of that, people have been very engaged. And like I said before, they're outside more often. They're much more invested in how their environment looks, and that is trash.
And some of that trash, the new pollutant that the pandemic has presented, is masks, right?
Yeah, so PPE is definitely the new pollution. And I think that it's a really exciting kind of pollution because people haven't seen it before, right? Like, we're not used to seeing masks on the ground. But to kind of put it in perspective, for every mask a volunteer picked up last year, they picked up 43 cigarette butts. They picked up 30 pieces of foodware packaging. They picked up 91 plastic fragments. So while PPE is definitely prevalent and we see it, I think we're seeing it while also not seeing everything else. While it has been very difficult, we haven't been able to get out and have fun with our volunteers, and I can't count how long. It's really, really pressed upon the importance of having a healthy and available and accessible public outdoor space.
When this pandemic is in our rearview mirror and we've had a chance to see its impact, what do you think is going to stand out as how it affected the environment here in San Diego?
I think when COVID's behind us, one of the biggest things we're going to take with us is, at least from my lens, how much disposable items are just a part of our culture. I've always been really, really careful to use bulk bins and try to avoid plastic packaging when I can. But during the pandemic, it's been intensely difficult to do that. So I think it's really shown us food packaging, just this disposable lifestyle that we've become so accustomed to, is really impacting our environment and is really hard to work around. And that we really need to push for legislation to do away with that kind of unnecessary disposable product.
That is also why Alex says the Surf Rider Foundation is calling on President Biden to be a plastic-free president and use the buying power of the federal government to reduce plastic and have single-use plastic not prevalent in federal buildings or in national parks. As for the executive orders on climate the president signed last week, she says the most hopeful aspect is the new administration's interest and belief in science and data.